Hey everyone, it's Anthony Ramos. Okay, 2020, finally time to say goodbye, but it's time to say hello to a brand new season of RuPaul's Drag Race. So excited to be talking to all the ladies, but right now I've got Elliott with two T's, LaLa Ri, Denali, and Joey J. Ladies, how you doing?
Work.
Yeah, you go.
All right, let's kick things off. I'm going to put you all on the spot. I want you to tell me your strategy to snatch the crown using only one word. Elliott, you are first.
Bulldoze them hoes.
That's cheating. That's more than one, but I will.
Okay. Okay, good.
LaLa, for you?
Slay.
Slay. Denali.
I'm going to say stunt.
Stun. Joey J.
Laxative. Fuck all you.
I've heard some crazy responses, but that is definitely the craziest. So there we go. Elliott with two T's. Okay. So I read your housewife meets J-Lo. Did I get that correct?
Yeah, I don't necessarily mean like Latin pop diva. I just mean like in the mindset of like when she's on the red carpet, she's like, you know, very pristine, put together. She's a mom, she's a wife, like very put together. But then on stage, she's just ass, hair, shake, twirl. Like, you know, I kind of relate in the way that she's like, she has the two different sides of her as a performer.
I love like the two T's of Elliott. There's the two
exactly.
Sides.
Exactly. Right? See, it all makes sense.
I love it. Okay. LaLa Ri. Okay. A lot of people, including my dog right here, are very excited to see how this all unfolds with your drag mother, Tamisha Iman. So she had some very nice things to say about you when I spoke to her a couple minutes ago. So what was the experience like for you?
It was pretty good. I like to say that it was a reunion for us because I kind of ran away from Tamisha Iman and we kind of reunited on the show. So it was really a surprise to see her there, but it was amazing to share that moment with her.
All right. All right. More to come there. Yeah. Denali. Okay. So you are a skating queen and also a martial arts queen. So how did those skills kind of enhance your Drag Race experience?
Well, ice skating is the gayest sport in the world. So I had a lot of practice being queer and fabulous. So when it came time to become a drag queen, the crossover was really easy. You know, the sparkles, the diamonds, the drama, the performance aspect of it all. It was basically just trading in my skates for heels.
All right. I like it. I can't wait to see all that. Joey repping Arizona.
What a bitch.
That's right. What does it mean for you to be a part of the Drag Race world when literally it's the best place to be? The entire world is watching it. It wins every award. It's the best.
It's quite an honor. I'm so excited. We do have one other queen from Arizona, Tempest Du Jour, but we've never had anyone from Phoenix. And my drag is a little bit like, it's not as traditional as other people's drag. And Phoenix, I feel, is so overlooked, and I'm so excited that Phoenix finally has a spotlight on it, because there is really good drag here in Phoenix. Like spooky drag, like we've got Dolly from Dragula. We have some of the most amazing like pageant girls here in Phoenix, like polished, pristine. Like it is such a great drag city, and I'm just so excited that like finally it's going to be recognized.
Representing, I love it. Okay, Elliott with two T's, having a little cocktail. I see there, very nice.
No, of course not, never.
The lip sync for your life element being brought in right away has people losing their marbles. What was it like for you to kind of just arrive and say, "Oh, I have to do all this right now"?
Losing my marbles, like I'm on the same page with everyone else. Like it is such. Even though you're always told don't have any expectations, don't expect it to be any type of way, you still kind of think, okay, we're all going to walk into the workroom. We're all going to meet each other. We're all going to kiki. RuPaul's going to come in. Hello, hello, hello. Like you just kind of have a little bit of an inkling that it should be that way. So the fact that it just was completely something that you can't even like make a comparison to from past seasons. Like you can't even like reference like, oh, they did something similar to this in this season. Like there was nothing to refer to. There was no way to wrap your head around it.
Denali, how was that for you?
I hated it.
Truth.
You know, it was just a real gag. It was a huge surprise. And even when you have a challenge, you know, and you kind of know the format, you can expect there's going to be a lip sync at the end of said challenge. So to come right in guns a-blazing and have to lip sync immediately was quite a shock to the system. And it definitely made us all go, okay, this is season 13 and I got to buck up and get ready because you never know what the hell is coming at you.
I could not agree more. Joey J, so do the girls in Arizona know how to lip sync for their lives?
Ooh. Oh, yeah.
I want to go to LaLa because, you know, when you're in Drag Race world, you know, you're a celebrity skyrockets. Everyone gets to know you. And I think there is a responsibility. So, you know, being one of our Georgia girls, I would love for you to remind everyone, because we are in the moment, January 5th, there is an election runoff. LGBTQ rights are at stake. Why is it important for people to remember to show up and vote in Georgia on January 5th?
Yeah, because our lives depend on it, point blank and the period. I made sure that I early voted, and I recommend everyone to early vote if you can. Plenty facilities around the Georgia area for you to early vote right now, but our lives literally depend on it. So go out and vote, honey.
Vote
if you can.
Vote for your lives. Exactly. Okay.
Yes, vote for your lives.
I'm going to wrap it up with a little fun thing because my friends and I know our two favorite things are Drag Race, of course, and also Real Housewives. And I feel like the fandom, there's definitely some crossover. So I want you to tell me what your housewife tagline would be. Elliott with two T's, what would your Real Housewives tagline be?
I'm a Las Vegas housewife with a secret.
Yeah. LaLa Ri for you.
These girls work jobs, but I am a job.
That's a good one.
That is a good one. Yes. Joey J, Arizona housewife. What would your Real Housewives tagline be?
Maybe if I'm not at the bar, it's because I'm raising it.
Oh! And love that. And then Denali, some Chicago Real Housewives tagline. What would it be?
I would say I'm an icy honey that's going to steal all your money.
Yes.
Oh. Yeah.
You all got it. I love it. Well, congratulations. We can't wait to see what happens for RuPaul's Drag Race season 13, which is starting January 1st on VH1, MTV, the CW. It's everywhere. It's a big deal. Lady,
everywhere.
Thank you so much. Good luck. And I'll hopefully see you in person very soon.
Yay. Yeah. Thank you for having
thank
us.
Thank you, Anthony.
Great.
So good meeting you. And work with the jacket. Yes.